Fallout 4 is one of my all-time favorite games, but all I do in it is settlement build. So today I'm bringing you with me and we are going to work on Tenpines Bluff. I started a new save and I'm just using console commands to skip everything else in the game. So we're only doing settlement building. We are, of course, the general of the Minutemen. So let's get started.
The first thing I'm gonna do is set up a radio beacon so we can get some more settlers to get some jobs. What am I looking for? Recruitment radio beacon. Now, Tenpines Bluff is a smaller settlement up here in the north of the Commonwealth. It has two people living here already in this little shack. So they've got these two mattresses. They do seem to be sheltered, so we can just leave them there. But this is pretty ugly. So let's go ahead and just scrap all this other stuff in it, because they don't really need empty bottles, right? They can keep the chair. The chair seems okay. But I'm gonna move it. Oh, I can't move these beds. Never mind, the beds are staying where they are. I think right here, because here's where you enter the settlement. So like imagine you're walking in. I think that having some sort of guard barracks up here would be nice. Oh, is this a new settler? Yes, we already got one. Hi.
Hey, I just wanted to introduce myself.
Hi.
I wanted to personally thank you for giving us this opportunity.
You are so welcome.
I'm ready to help with whatever you need. Just say the word.
Great.
Yeah, let me show you.
Sure.
I don't have anything for you yet, so you just hang on. Because I am going to build some barracks. The ground's uneven, so we're going to even it out with one of these foundations. Why won't it let us? Maybe like that and that. No, that's kind of in the bush. That feels better. Then only a little bit will be poking through, and that's okay. Yeah, I like that. Smack a door on. I've always hated that there's only one door option. Like, I want door variety. We've got some steps. Yep, that works. And then I usually like to make my barracks like double decker. What's the word for that? Multi-story. So we'll throw on a wall. And then I'm doing it this way so I know the stairs fit, because we got to put another door on the second story. There we go. And we'll put these smaller stairs. Or do we want the stair with this? You know what I mean? Because that fits kind of nice. Ooh, that fits good though. Yeah, because then they'll just walk right up the stairs. And then they're up here on the second level. Yeah, love that. We should give them a little railing so nobody falls off. There and there. I did not think through a door, though. I don't know which way the door opens. That might be inconvenient. Oh, no, that's delightful. So we've got the second story set up here. And now we can finish building out the first story. Let's do blue feels Minuteman-y, right? We want to represent the Minutemen here, because that's how we're rebuilding the Commonwealth. We can do... Maybe I can't. That feels like it's jutting out too much, so maybe let's do a flat wall. But something that still feels, you know, yeah, textured enough to be interesting. And then what I'd like to do on the second story is keep it this flat wall so we can decorate it with the Minuteman flag. Because that way, right when you walk into the settlement, you know who the settlement is aligned to. Like that. Yeah. So, you know, it's not pretty because it's Fallout, but you get the vibe that that is a Minuteman-owned settlement and the barracks staring straight ahead. Mm-hmm. Oh, we can't get up there. Well, that's good. It makes it more secure, but it is annoying for actually building it. Mm-hmm. I don't want to prefab, but we can use one of the walls that pop out to give this sort of like a you're overseeing feeling. And then we'll use the half walls to keep that sealed up because we still want it to feel secure. Is this the same wall I used on this side? No, that'll be good. That's nice. And then we got to finish off the upstairs. This one, it can be a little airier because we're less worried about break-ins on the second floor. Not that break-ins are a thing that happen, but just, you know, immersively. We'll get to Abernathy Farm at some point, but we're starting with the basics. Better to just let them take what they want. Okay. Let's do a floor covering first before we put down any beds. And now I think we can fit two beds comfortably up here. Beds, beds. There we go. But we need them to be the skinny kind so they can fit comfortably. So I'll scooch one in here on the left, and then one here on the right. I like to think that these beds up here are, like, one of them would be open to people just kind of traveling through, so I want to make sure they have somewhere to put their stuff. So I'm going to drop a footlocker at the base of each, so whoever takes these beds has somewhere to, you know, kind of feel settled. But then we can put a chair or two up here because we have some room to make this feel cozier. Yeah, let's do like a classic. Yeah. And then we can pop a table down there too. I actually don't know if I'm gonna have access to the candles I wanna use yet. Do I? Is that in decorations? There we go. I love these candles. I feel like they make everything feel a little more homey. And then this side, we don't have anything going on. So let's put a painting up. These people are working on a farm. So let's put a little farm painting. And that feels nice. So this is the upstairs of the barracks. We've got small table, small chair, and then two beds with footlockers for either guards or people who are just passing through. And now let's handle the downstairs. For the downstairs, I'm envisioning this as being where the guards officially sleep. Oop. So we'll do one, two beds. And then over here, I feel like there should be a desk. I think that's a container. Because imagine, you know, if you're captain of the Minuteman guards in here, you would want to be able to sit down and assign daily schedules and stuff. Yeah, good rolly chair. So that way you can figure out scheduling for everybody in the settlement, because head guard here, of course, is going to have to look out for everybody. A little more lighting for visibility. Okay, so we got the desk. We've got these two beds. And then I feel like we need something here. Ooh, I know what we need. I just don't know where it is. Yes, there we go. That should not have been hard to find. But we can pop up a weapon rack, because I would imagine that they can kind of check out weapons and restore them and stuff here. Containers, I want, yeah, like the big cabinet. Yeah, that feels appropriate. So this is where our guards can live, and they've got the cabinet and the weapon rack for storing their equipment, desk to work out scheduling and stuff. And then they've got two beds. I feel like they should have maybe a decoration on the wall. Maybe not. Maybe they just need like a little welcome rug for their dirty boots. Yeah, that feels good. That feels appropriate. So there are our barracks. I love that. And then, of course, if we're going to have guards, we need something for them to guard. So let's go into guard posts. Yeah. Plop one down like that. And like that. Yeah, that's beautiful. So if we exit workshop mode, and we imagine we're just coming up to the settlement. Oop, that one's poking forward. Ugh. We gotta pull this one back so it doesn't float. There. Yeah, that feels better. Okay. So I'm walking up to Tenpines Bluff for the first time. Guard one, guard two, and the barracks right behind it. That is beautiful. I do feel like there should be some artillery defending as well. Also, did I forget to scrap this tree, or is this not scrappable? That's not scrappable. All right. Well, here's what we can do. Not furniture, but a miscellaneous wood structure. I love using this shack bridge to prop up defenses. So now that we've put that up there, we can get our turret. We'll get the good turrets and just pop them up here like this. Yeah, that's nice. That way anybody trying to come in, you know, to do harm, any raiders or anything that come our way, we can get them. Okay, we do have people working on the farming already. That came, you know, default as part of the settlement. What else can we scrap around here? Broken toilet? Yeah. Cinder blocks. They look like they're structurally needed, but they're not. Branch pile? Get rid. Ooh, water pump we do need, but I'll move it. There we go. I feel like we don't really need this grill. I hope they're not mad if I get rid of their grill. Okay. So walk in here. And then we have this old structure. And what I've always hated about Tenpines Bluff is you can't get rid of this structure. It's just here. So we can build on top of it. We can try and make it like a shopping center. Let's get rid of that mattress. Let's get rid of the refrigerator. And branch and tricycle. Oh, dead rad roach. We can take some meat. What are we gonna do with this? Well, we're definitely gonna need a clinic. Ooh, do we have a new settler?
Anything I can do to help out around here?
Heck yeah.
Yeah, let me show you.
Go ahead.
Okay, I feel like this would be a good area for our clinic. Just because it's kind of out of the way a bit. So let's start again with the foundation. Oop, we'll adjust that so it's not underground. But the way that I like to do my clinics is sort of in this L shape, just because I think it's enough room to hold the actual like clinic store, While still providing some privacy, which, you know, is important for our lore. So we'll smack the door on there, get some stairs. Well, maybe we don't need stairs because it's so close to the ground already. Oop, don't know what I did. Let's try and pull it out a little bit. Yeah, that feels okay. I guess they can just walk right in without stairs. And then I like putting on a shack wall to give us some more wiggle room. Because again, fitting the clinic inside, it's kind of a stretch sometimes. Oh no, we're too far. We're too close to the edge of the map. We gotta pull this back. Come back, come back. There we go. And you'll see what I mean with that. For clinics, I like to use these walls just because they feel the cleanest. Oh, we are gonna have to pull up the structure if we want that to. Maybe this wall's the problem. Oh, yeah. And now we just have to try and pop it back on. Again, really wish we had more than one doorway. Now we can put the stairs on though. That's nice, that's not too shabby. And I want that nice wall again. There we go. And let's pop the other half wall on this little storage section. Why can't, there we go. Oh, I was worried that I wouldn't be able to for a sec. And then roof, we'll do that way. There, okay. Let's do the outside first. So we wanna put a door on that. Obviously. I feel like red would work well for a clinic, but white I think would feel cleaner. And then what I like to do here is actually use the mute fruit tree, use the mute fruit tree as a little like decoration because it kind of feels like a hedge. You know what I mean? So it just makes things a little cozier. And then of course we want people to be able to find the clinic in the dark. So I'm gonna pop down a fire barrel. And then I also want from the wall decorations, there's a sign that says drugs. There we go. I love putting this on the clinic. It just feels like a nice little, come and get it. Come and get those stim packs. And I'm gonna move the fire barrel a little closer. That feels nice. That's how our clinic is gonna look from the outside. But of course we gotta fill it up, fill it up with stuff too. Let's start with a welcome mat again, just cause I feel like that's, you know, welcoming. And it's important in a clinic to feel welcoming. People overlook that. I want to do a little waiting room. So I'm looking, there's like a narrow couch. Is that it? This'll work. So I'm going to pop the couch into our little waiting area. And then I'm looking for a locker. There we go. To put next to it. With the idea being that when you come to the clinic, you know, you might have to change out of your clothes and you want somewhere safe to put your stuff. So that's where that's what that is for. And then I love these little animal paintings for the clinic because it's like, I feel like that's what you'd see in a doctor's office who is, you know, kids as patients because you want them to feel comfy. And then I want a potted plant. Yeah. Well, not that one, because that one's dead. Yeah, just like that. It's really dark in here, so you can't really appreciate this, but let me see if I can grab, yep, a medical cart. Yeah. Just like that. So I can pop some lighting on it. Instead of using the candles in here, I'm going to use the oil lamp just because it's a little cleaner for a medical setting. There we go.
The farm's not much.
Actually, I can turn on. Stop talking. I can turn on my Pip-Boy so you can see this in the green light. But there's our little waiting room set up, and I think it's really pleasant. And then the bed that I like to use for the clinics is the one that comes with the vault workshop because it feels a lot cleaner. So I feel like that's what they would use. That's what the doctor would use to sleep, but it's also where like checkups would happen. So I love using that one. And then I don't want a rug here, but I do want like a rubber floor covering because it feels kind of clinical. Yeah, like that. Okay, that's feeling good. Okay, so now I can squeeze the clinic in here. I'm just checking we have enough room to walk around it on every side. Yes, we do. Okay, that looks really good. Let's put a shelf behind them for storage. And then, of course, if they're going to be performing surgeries, I want them to be able to wash their hands. I want it to go right there. Oh, yes. There we go. So now as the doctor, you can wash your hands before coming over here to help your patients. I want another rug down here. That's decorations. Yeah, there we go. That's really nice. Although we could use another light back here, but I also think it's just getting dark out. So let's actually try out this bed and sleep for 12 hours straight, as one does. Ah. Well rested. Oh yeah, it looks so much better here in the daytime. We've got Preston waiting for his checkup in the little waiting area that we've made. We gotta assign somebody to the clinic. So let's find one of our new settlers. We'll leave the original people here to tend the farm. But this lady was new.
Can't remember the last time I had clean fingernails.
Well, you would need to wash your hands if I make you a doctor.
I just wanna trade a few things.
Sure thing.
And then I know I have a lab coat on hand. Because I like people to dress the part. Yeah, that's nice.
Got it.
There we go. Now we have a clinic and a doctor at that clinic. Okay, the Brahmin walking everywhere is a big problem for me. That's very nice. And then he can get out of the way of everybody else here. And then we have to come back and figure out what to do with this. We can get rid of the bathtub, that's for sure. I wonder if we could put something over it and then make that the housing, you know? So if we get, yeah, like that looks to be the right wall height. Let's get a better wall though. Like if I do, I'm gonna wedge it right in the corner there if I can. That. Actually, how many of these do we need to fill the space? I'm hoping this just, oh, I did not think it would be that perfect, but that is so perfect. That's beautiful. Because then we could put housing above that, you know what I mean? Maybe. Oh no, is there something blocking it on this side? I'll cry. I will. Fallout 4, I love you, but not this. Can we scooch it any more left? Oh, I shouldn't have picked it up. Uh-oh. Oh my god, I can't believe that worked. Okay. Okay, so now we've got some structure repaired. Can we do another wall to finish this? Ooh. Yeah, that looks pretty nice. I mean, it's not perfect, but we've at least given this some, you know, we fixed it up some. I don't hate that at all. Okay, I feel like now that we have this structure, this could be really good as like a shopping center. So if I get like a general trader, oh no, it won't fit there. But will this fit? Oh yeah, that'll fit. That's fine. Yeah. And this guy, hey buddy.
Sure.
Yes, you're a general trader now. And I'd like to add some lights in here. Yeah, like string lights. We're gonna put the generator out back. And we'll use, I think we need one of these things. There we go. Yeah. Because now when we come around here, he's got this nice little general store set up. Oh, that's cute. I feel like as the owner of a general store, he needs some more storage. Like this could be... That'll be fun for him. And then a chair, because we don't want him on his feet all day. That's not fair for, you know, retail workers should all have chairs. This is an uncomfortable one, but it is Fallout. So there you go. That's nice. Okay, and then what over here? I feel like our other store options, we could do a clothing stall or a restaurant. Restaurant would be nice because then people would have somewhere to eat. But I feel like clothing would actually balance out this better, and then we can do a restaurant somewhere over here. And then people come in when they need clothing. We don't have anybody we can assign to that yet, but that's okay. We're still attracting settlers. I'll put up another string lights. Oh, good, that reaches. That looks nice. And then we want to be able to display our wares. So I think that adding, yeah, some people here to demonstrate that we have clothing to sell, which of course we don't yet, but we will. Shelves. If I put shelves here, is there room to still walk through? Let's test it. Yes, there is. Perfect. And then we'll add another chair. Because again, people deserve to sit while they work. That one looks weird. There's too many legs. That one's better. There we go. Okay, that is looking really lovely as our shopping center. I want some more like decoration pieces, and I feel like floor covering could be good for that. This rug feels too homey, but going back to like the rubber flooring, this could be a really good opportunity for rubber flooring. Those are all too big, but if we scatter some of these around, yeah, that feels nice. That feels nice. Okay, perfect. So now we got to address this upper section. What I'm hoping we can do is have like housing up there, you know what I mean? And then this will be like, oh, but wait, because these could pop out and then look really nice. If that fits, would that fit? That might not fit. Actually, I don't like that. Never mind. Scrap that. We're going back to this. Okay, see, now the second row can be housing. And that can be nice. I want to try the wall, the extended wall thing again over here, though. Is there a way to clip it in? I don't think so. What about on this side? Ooh, there is on that side. I don't hate that. That looks neat. Okay, perfect. And then we'll seal it up. Can I reach? Yes, I can. And we'll put this wall back because we can't do another side thing there. Okay, that looks really nice. We have our little shopping center. What is tripping me? Still these rat roaches. Okay, we have our little shopping center. And then we have this on top. And then we grab some stairs. It doesn't quite reach the ground. That's not really a problem because we can just, that still won't reach the ground. But if we do, or no, we'll use the other stairs. Like this. Yeah, that's not too weird. I mean, it's a little weird. Can this go down as like a... Nope, I guess that'll just be unsupported. That's okay. Because now when we come up here, we have a door to the inside, and that's pretty great. And roofs, of course. We'll just do a flat roof because we're high up. Okay, I don't love how long this is. I don't know what we can do about that, but that's okay. Are we gonna have room for a door here? The door is gonna open the wrong way, isn't it? That's very annoying. Because if I put that door there, it's gonna open like that, yeah. Well, how much room do we have left in the settlement? Not like a ton. Okay, we can do this because we want them to be able to open the door. Okay, that appears to be where the cutoff is. That's okay. And then we don't want people just plopping off, you know, so. Can't put that on? Okay. That's fine. We'll do these smaller ones. The way this game chooses to clip will always be a mystery to me. We can go like that. That's fine. I won't ever look behind there, and you guys promise not to either. Because I feel like a chair could be nice here. Like a bench? Yeah. And then we'll pretend we did this whole thing on purpose. Okay, so we got a little bench, and then you come up here, and then you're inside.
Delightful. That's not too bad. Yeah, because if we zoom out, we still have this lovely, like, mall structure. So you come up here, and you come in this back door. Okay, so what do we need? We need beds. So let's go back to this bed design, which I enjoy. Actually, let's throw down a rug first. Some little rocket chips. Bed one, bed two. Everybody gets a roommate. It's just like college, but it's the post-apocalypse. Okay, they can have, because this is more permanent residence than the first one we did. Let's do a little dresser. And we'll find my favorite candles to put on top of the dresser, wherever they are. I always forget if they're in decorations or furniture, but I guess it makes sense that they're in decorations, huh? That's nice. I want like a painting or maybe some chairs. Ooh, they have room for a proper couch. So maybe do like a real couch in here, which will help fill out that long space. Oh yeah, that's nice. That feels much cozier. And then we'll do a painting. Painting or flag, because flag would remind them that they're here because of the Minutemen, which is always nice. Maybe that would cover up that weird part of the wall better. Unless there's a big painting. Ooh, I do like a big painting. Yeah, I like that. That feels so cozy and homey. And then what we can do over here is give them a little sitting area, you know, a little kitchenette. If we find a nice table, yeah, like that. I just need like a dining chair. Nope, I feel like I'm going the wrong way. Yeah, a nice dining chair. That's nice, because then they can sit here and have breakfast as they look out over the settlement, and they've got their beds and this cozy sitting area. Okay, I love this. We have some blank space here, and you know what? My favorite way to fill blank space is plants. Shocker. And let's see if we can find a good welcome mat. Just a nice little rug. Yeah, okay, so now you come up this weird back alley. You've got a little rug, you've got a little plant, a seating area, couch, dresser, beds. This is a nice little apartment. It's like a studio apartment. Okay, beautiful. Now we can come back here. So what are we missing? We have clothing, we have shopping, we have a clinic. We do not have a bar or a restaurant, so that's probably what we should work on next. And this is the last kind of open space that we have. So I feel like this is where it's gonna go. Now, I love for restaurants using the warehouse set. I don't know why, it just has a grip on me that nothing else can compete with. There's just something about it. Let's pull this a little out, actually. Ooh, that's actually really nice. I thought that would sink into the hill more. I don't really mind these bushes sticking out. There's not much we can do about that, so. It is what it is. Pop on a door. Yeah. Come up in here.
Let's do like a nice window door, because this is going to be a bar / restaurant. Yeah, okay. And I love that they have walls with a lot of windows. Yeah. I think that's really nice. I'm sure there are more complicated structures that you can make out of this warehouse set, but I keep the bars I do pretty simple. And then there's a nice roof that does the four corners kind of comfortably. One, two, three, four. And now that we have a bar established here, I'm gonna move the feed trough a little farther away. Let's actually, while we're out here, throw in some picnic tables. Like, that's nice. Put some lamps up. And then really you just need one light bulb to sort of light up the whole thing. And we'll throw an open sign on there too. Yeah. And of course that needs power. So let's get a generator going. That has power, that has power. It's gonna look really good at night. Let's make the bar. Uh-oh, why won't it go there? There we go. I'll align it a little better. That's nice. Okay, so you come in, there's the bar. And there is a sign that I know that I want. Yeah, the liquor sign. It feels like a bar if you ignore the branches coming through the flooring. but now I want to put some benches. Yeah, these benches. I feel like they fit really well in here. And they'll kind of snap together, which is so nice. Yeah, that's coming together. And then this counter thing, I don't know what you're supposed to use it for, but I love using it as kind of like a separator. Because if I pop it on, now I'm looking for the radio. There we go. Little Diamond City radio here in our bar. Because now people can come in, they can grab a drink, they can listen to some music. Well, you know what I want to do is put a chair back here. Maybe some rubber flooring. More comfortable than standing on concrete, I think. There we go. So whoever works here can sit on that. Okay, that's looking really nice. So there's our bar. Yeah. And some outdoor seating. Shopping center, housing, clinic. Wow, this is feeling really good. Oh, metal bucket that we can scrap. I see we have 5 people now, so I think somebody came in. Were you one of the originals? No, you're the original settler, so you actually can come with me and work in the bar. Okay, so we have the 2 original settlers who are farmers, 1 doctor, one general goods, and one restaurant owner. So that's our five people. I'm hoping to get a few more so we can do two guards, because I think that'll balance things out nicely. This does not need to be here. This probably shouldn't be here. Let's move this closer to the farm. And of course, once we've recruited everybody, we'll get rid of this because kind of an eyesore. I wish there was more that we could do with this little house. Actually, I know what we can do. We can make this a scrapper house. A little scavenger setup, so it feels more appropriate that there's junk in here, which would mean that we need another settler to come along and be assigned to this workstation, but that's okay. I think if we just keep this running for a bit, it'll pad itself out nicely. Well, I think that's it for now. You know, we'll come back, we'll check in on them. Hopefully they attract some more settlers and their happiness rating comes up a little bit, but that's Tenpines Bluff. Thank you for joining me, the General of the Minutemen, today, and I'll see you next time. Thank you for watching to the end. You definitely didn't have to do that. Be sure to give me a like and a follow. It really helps me out, and I appreciate you. I'll see you next time.